Yeah.
So the rest of the season hasn't been. Yeah. Most of the season hasn't been that fruitful for him.
Relies a lot on set shots to kick a lot of his goals too.
Look at the umpire here.
David Chaston, right in front of us. Umpire holds it aloft to get this game started, and it's Fanning versus Vale. Vale just will stand his ground, reaches up, knocks it down. Far as Condy, Rob that is. His kick smothered. Oh, trying to crash his way through Bell Park. Kick is marked. Right in front of us at Ianelli, who takes the mark. No, I'm sorry, that is Stack. Hutchison gets it, kicks it forward. Crumbs goes to Rawlings again, who was the player who cleared it out of the middle. He's tackled immediately, and we'll have a ball up. Half forward for Bell Park.
Yeah, so the Rucks get around this one. It's Fanning going up against Vale. They just slung each other out of there, and the ball just hit the deck, and then it was quickly wrapped up. She's going nowhere. As Lockie Patton.
Was Vale a bit stiff not to get a free there?
I reckon he might have been, but in saying that, maybe they had arms around each other. Mm-hmm. How's the wind taking a hold of that ball up? It really got head high, and it still went 3 metres to the left. Ground level, they're all just diving in again. Vale came in and got on top of it, and the tackle there by Billy Laurie, who was on fire in the first quarter last week.
Wasn't he? Didn't he get up to an absolute fire?
He had the sticky hands going.
Up they go again. Over the top, this man, third man up, is Billy Laurie. Ball comes out. Leading player on that occasion is Anderson. He muffs it, comes back out the back to Hutchison. What can he do? Tries to play tunnel ball. Can't hang on to it. Rolls over it. Umpire circling. Give it to me. He says we'll have a ball up right in front of the kicks commentary track.
Got to be doing a lot of work today, the umpires.
New sign.
That's what, four stoppages already.
So they go up again. Look at him. There's a couple of free kicks there, but just let him go on a day like this. Braddock gets the clearance. He's just thrown it on the boot going forward. Lynch was good with a fist, brought it back in board. That's good stuff there. I reckon that might have been Ianelli. He's got it forward, and he found Rawlings. He takes it on the chest on centre wing, right in front of us in there, in front of Fanning as well. And he's just chipped it up into the forward 50. He needs a fly. Garth was at the back. He came charging up, but Robin's got a hand on it. They bring it back towards centre half forward, did Bell Park. Garth ended up with, he got from Sheringham. Now it's with Stack. He just spears one 3 metres. Garth took it on the chest and then grabbed one towards goal. It's just going to keep bouncing there towards it. Nelson Brown, so I'm trying to work out, that was Kerman who got back there, and he's just kicked one out across the face. And
deliberate?
I reckon it might be deliberate. No, we'll have a throw in deep inside Bell Park.
Chance to make a name for himself there. The umpire could have done the old right in front of the crowd.
Set the stage
That's
early.
It, exactly.
Today's not the day for it, surely.
This throw in, 30 around from the Bell Park goal. Kicking into what this strong wind, Sheringham. Jackson tries to crash his way through, gets tackled. Umpire says, give it to me. We'll have a ball up now in the same spot. 25 out from the Bell Park goal. So far, doing all the attacking. Garth uses his body, pushes the man out, gets the ruck work off the deck. Well, trying to, that was Farrell. He's tackled, goes across to Sandy Robertson. Good smother from the Bell Park player in. That's he's at it again, bloody Rawlings. He's had a great first quarter.
He's been everywhere, isn't he? He looks like one who might love these conditions.
Yeah,
might know who he is soon.
Well, I did have to stand up, and I couldn't work out who the heck was there.
So thrown back into play there, and the wind took it, and the Rovers had to do the ruck work. It ended up with Condy, who just gets on that left slipper and gets it out of the area. Lynch was at the front on the wing, got a fist out of it, picking it up now as Vale gives it over top to Lynch, who was intercepted by Fanning. House picks it up, ends up with Mick Condy, just gets on the left boot going forward, getting across Ben Johnson, did well. He just knocked it to the advantage of a teammate there. But really good stuff there from the Newtown forwards, put on plenty of pressure. I reckon that was Chincotta, as well as Fanning.
Just swapped in on him then.
So the hands were given to Condy. He gets it about 60 out. He's just going to spear it into the pocket. Good stretch, almost mark taken back there. Dolly. Reckon that was Dolly, yeah. So, and a free kick awarded in the end for a sling against Dolly. I reckon it might have been, or holding the man, something along those lines.
Sheringham was holding on to him a little bit. He played it up nicely. Got the umpire's attention.
Looks like it'd be the first score.
So that way this wins, yeah, and it could be anything.
He'd have the assistance, wouldn't he, right up his backside?
You'd think so, yeah. Hard one to judge here. I think it was Wally who had a really rough day here last year trying to judge it.
Yeah, no, I reckon the wind is coming right over his shoulder.
So Dolly, he'll kick from, I'd say, about 45. Still got a little bit of a journey to carry, but he should be able to do the job, kick on its way. The umpire's done a little bit of work, and he's just pulled it to the right-hand side there. So the first score of the day is a minor score to Newtown. That's on your Blood Toyota scoreboard.
Yeah, probably should have made more of that. It wasn't that critical a kick.
Yes. You're not going to get a lot of chances today.
No. I wouldn't have thought you were going to get a lot of set shots either, because marking's going to be difficult inside forward 50.
Fenstead kicks to himself, then Pass kicks it to Jackson Sheringham. Takes the mark at half back. Garth is providing a lead on the wing. Up he goes. Fisted away by Hinkley. As he'll do all day, he knocks that out of bounds. More than happy to do that all day, I reckon, Big Hinkley.
How's Garth, though, trying to stretch him early on? Look at all the players pushing up the field here, too.
Yeah, you expect a lot of numbers around the ball if both teams will want some space in their 50.
So Fanning got into a good position and got the tap down. Didn't quite work out for his Rovers trying to get through. Bell Parker being strong in the contest. Ian Ali had it. And there's about 10 players, 10, 20 players around this contest here. It's pretty hard to get out of there.
There's going to be a lot of this today.
Yep. So we'll have another ball up, about 70 around from the Newtown goal.
I was just thinking, if this was Joey's and Newtown again in these conditions, we'd have no hope. Because they won't have to tell apart.
At least pretty ordinary.
Difference here. Still in tight. Vail tries to work his way through. Tackled. Umpire says we'll go do all that again. Another ball up. Low scoring. I reckon 8 goals a win today. There you go. Vail threw a boot at it because he had him spun around.
Went in the back
there.
Heel.
Yes. Johnson leads in the race. Tries to keep it in. Can't do so. And we'll have a throw in. He's on Hocking. So I'm just trying to find House. Yeah, House. Baxter's got House. Baxter House. There you go, boys. Hey.
No, you always bring your worst material to this ground. So, throwing back into play, and once again, they all dive on it. We're going nowhere.
That was actually not bad. That was straight off. Boom.
Yeah, you're bad.
Quick. Bang.
There was no stuttering or anything like that. You just spat it out in some real quick time. It's thrown up. Cam Lewis is there. He just gathers it. He's tying the line. And there's a free kick all in amongst all of them. Look who he's getting there. That'll be Matty McMahon. He's too far out to score, I would have thought. So he's just going to sit it up to the hot spot. He needs a leader. The forward House was the one he was the intended target. But Ben Johnson, who just loves taking a couple of marks.
He was off. Don't worry about that.
He was off. He took three or four and said, I'm in a bit of strife, and went backwards. He's just chipped it out to the pocket. They just looked at each other. Stack said, I don't want to go near the bloody thing. Eventually had to go after it. He threw his body on top of it. He's working real hard in there. Newtown, though, they got the numbers as they try to break out. That was Tim Cotter getting involved. Then out the back there, that was Alford for Bell Park. He went out towards the line. Rawlings is over it. The line, they're just looking for it, and I thought it was there as they all stopped, and eventually the umpires called for it as it's crossed it.
Stoppage number's got to be up to almost 15 by now.
There'll be a lot
just
of them.
Ticking over.
Spinning ball back in. 50 out from the Newtown goal. Vail might have won that one. Knocks it down as far as Ben said. He's wrapped up straight away. Umpire says, nah, give it to me. We'll have another ball up. Should have kept the stat on these.
Yeah.
Because I reckon there'll be heaps of them today.
Yeah, a record.
Ten would have run out of ink.
And it'll get worse as the day progresses too. Vail drives a fist into it. Matty McMahon tries to pick it up. Can't do so. Ball might already be slippery, and they're circling. Look, umpire circle there. Umpire, say, just swap sides. We'll have a ball up. Whoop. A little bit of
feeling.
Yeah.
You're going to get that at some point with a game with plenty of stoppages.
Physicality.
Yeah. So he'll be thrown up on that outer side. Fanning, there's Vail just throwing a fist at it. He just knocked it further. A field didn't go far. It only went as far as Kerman. He just got it out the back. Now it's Anderson with it. He handballs it over the top. Getting a boot out of there was Dolly just around the corner. It's bounced up in front of Johnson. He had two to beat. He just stepped around Matty McMahon, gave the hands off. I think that was Henderson getting involved. He's just grabbed one up the wing. Kerman was at it again, got the hands out. Condy was there. He couldn't quite hold it. That was Mick.
Throw.
And he's been done for a throw.
Yep.
That's real stiff.
Slippery ball.
Yeah. I would have said that's more he just couldn't take possession of it.
Yep, he pinged him for a throw there. Which.
Yeah, so it's Jackson Sheringham. He's going to be the recipient. He's just going to go short. He's got Henderson who's worked for him. Barely the required distance.
Just come onto the ground. I reckon he's just snuck on.
Yeah. The kick up the line there wasn't a bad one. That found rounds. He'll love this sort of conditions as well. He's just brought it back in board. He found Harry Smith.
Jeez, that was 2 seconds.
So on that basis, Cyril Rioli has taken the mark of the century. As the ball comes back to Rounds, he gets it in the centre half forward. Going back and taking a good mark there is Chincotta. Or Sincotta, however you say it, I'm not sure.
He's had a little bit of it too so far.
Kicks it wide. One on three here for Bell Park. Excellent job there from Farrell. Gets it over to Lynch. What, he had three players to beat and he did the job. Ball goes in. Ian Alley
lost
it
up, little beauty.
Mark. Knocks it over to Lynch. Lynch spears the pass.
Oh, got it here.
Excuse me, it goes over to his teammate there who was all on his own in Louis Holmer and gets the first goal of the game.
That was brilliant from Charlie Farrell against the three of them there.
Absolutely.
His teammates went straight to him as they should. He was against three blokes.
Yep.
Gather it and then hit the target with the handball too. Look, it was just the over-the-head one. He went to the voice and nailed it.
And great follow-up work by Lynch. He's had a good year, Lynch. He two or three efforts on that occasion to get the ball to the goal square and set up the goal.
Absolutely, mate. And it was good work. He was involved in the passage of play down there with Johnson, if you remember. So yeah. He's ran the length of the ground just about.
Lynch having a good week too. I think he coached the St Joey's school team to the Herald Sun Shield final, which is on next week, I think, during the week.
Yeah, so they've obviously done more than watch basketball.
Exactly.
It's cool. Up they go again. Gee, yeah, I reckon Big Shorts has got that one again. Knocks it over. Come on. Picks it up. Goes for a little barrel. Picked off on this occasion by his teammate there in Lewis. Goes wide. It's almost picked up there by Paddy Bright. But then his teammate just drives a booty when it kicks it wide. Picked up by Braddock. Braddock goes to centre-half forward to Condi. Condi loose hands it. Looks like Kelly, who gift dishes it over. Comes back to Lewis. Lewis up and under kick. In the goal square is House. A good use of the body. Good work from Baxter as well on House. Oh, he might have given away a free kick. Has he? No. Umpire says that's okay. Baxter dishes off the handball. Gets it over to his teammate in Rounds. Rounds has got a target here in Holmer, but he's got come on to beat, and the ball goes over the boundary line. We'll have a throw in, almost centre wing.
Geez, he was unlucky there, House.
I reckon.
He had a fair piece of it the first time.
The ball almost bounced off his chest the first time, and then he got.
And then when he dived over his back.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, if he's gone over there and hasn't come back with a can of Coke, there's going to be. He hasn't brought me back a can of Coke. You are dead. You're dead to me.
We're thrown back into play on the wing. There was Vale, just got the tap down at the back of Stack. He's just thrown the right boot at it. He's got it going forward. Nelson Brown went back to the flight and he caught one in the jaw. I think that was Polky coming over the top there. Just got him with a stray arm. Kerman's got it, just shrugs Polky in there again, but then he just dropped the pill. Brown's still really slow to get up out the side here. Look at that, Smith in there laying a strong tackle on Kelly.
He'll be able to claim it was a stray arm there, Polk, but it was well-directed stray arm.
Yeah.
Straight into the bush.
Well, Nelson Brown's mum comes every week, so she'll be out there. It's when she's brought out the hanky to look after him. Jack Sheringham goes off the ground. That's Tim, almost to his brother. Fanning, should have picked that up, doesn't. Too high. It's a softie there, ump. That's a softie on a day like today. Fanning goes to centre-half forward to House, gets one hand. Baxter at ground level. Sheringham, Tim, tackled by two players. The umpire says, nah, give it to me. We'll have a ball up. That's the softest kick for the day, boys.
He didn't get him at all.
Nah.
It was a poor decision by Fanny as well when he had it. He had a clear ball and he chipped it 20 metres instead of going long. Can't be messing
with Bale got the tap down. Newtown with a kick out the back there from Kelly. Just got it going forward. It's come off hands and bring it to the front. Lewis is over the top of it. He's trying to get out. Sheringham scouting the pack and eventually dives on there. Out the back there, again, trying to get involved was Schwabrick.
Yeah, I'm glad you got that.
Schwabrick. I just wanted to get that one out early.
Yeah, Schwabrick.
And eventually we've got a stoppage in there as Benny Johnson gets off the bottom of the pack. So thrown up again, the Rucks will do battle. It's just knocked out towards the boundary line. Sitting underneath it was Rounds. He tried to break his way through. Condi had his head over it. Then dropping the ball was Laurie trying to charge. It was Rounds again. Went back and got it. He tripped and then got back up. Got it on the left boot. It's out towards Garth. Bounces over his head. Hinkley's at the back there. He's just going to gather it and throw it on the right boot. It's just napping under towards centre half forward. Gave to Florian House. Good set defensive work there from Baxter. But a free kick to House. Mate, what in the hell's going on there?
Same umpire that gave the high one to Fanning.
Have a spell, mate.
Yes. You can't be paying kicks like that today, champ.
You surely couldn't be. So House, he's about 60 out. He's not going to be giving this one a roost at the line. He's been called to play on. Garth tries to smash him as he kicks it, and his kick went wide out to the pocket in front of Sheehan, and eventually over the line. And through that fence now to the Carlos sort of area out there. It's a bit muddy. They don't want him getting bogged down there today.
And of course, the boundary can't get over the fence because there's assassins in the trees. They'll like, shoot him, beating him. Ridiculous crap. It just does my head in that. Get under the damn fence and get the footy. Boundary umpire throws it in. 20 around from Newtown goal. Fanny's got front spot. Flips it over the back. Jackson Sheringham gets one, then flips it over to Johnson. Johnson just around the body. McMahon traps it for Newtown. Dishes off the handball to Hinkley. Hinkley's hands. Up and under kick there.
That's out.
Reckon that was a good one. And then out in the full.
It's out where the runner went to hide earlier.
Yeah, haven't seen him yet, have we? Where'd that runner go?
He's still
come back.
He's sitting in the warmth of his car listening to us.
Condi, Rob. Oh, got in the barrel.
He's on the spiral.
Absolutely cracking
kick.
He did
not mean that.
I reckon he did.
Yeah, he dropped it like
that. Yeah, ball comes back. Jackson Sheringham just tumbles it forward over the top. Polky doesn't take the mark. Almost, though, at ground level. Good fist out there. Big Shorts leads in the race. Gets down ground level. Dishes off the handball. Comes over. Good work again there from Rawlings. But he's gone this time, I reckon. He is.
Poor Big Shorts. Yes. Not the day for him to be out in front like
the old sprint. What's he doing there, Big Shorts? Cut that out. Hocking goes to the hot spot. House has got two to beat. Up over the back, taking a good mark on that occasion is Elford.
Strong mark and with the wet ball to take it overhead like that. Nice and easy.
Yeah, that's it. And out in the wing, Braddock was first there. He had to work really hard against Patton. Got it out to Billy Lowe. He was tackled again. Braddock's gone back for it again. He's just dived over the top of it and absolutely no intention of trying to get that one out. So we'll have a ball up on that outer side. That's 70 around from goal. As the umpire just waits for the rucks. They're feeling the effects.
One goal plays 1 point at this stage, boys. Very low scoring.
Mick Condy's going to send this ball going forward again for Newtown. Ooh. Good roving there. I reckon that was Jim Cotter doing really well. He's just hit it towards a hot spot. House was good, but so was Baxter. He got the fist there towards the line. Sheehan will get there first. He was just knocked off and pushed over the line by Alford.
House had his name written all over that one. Didn't Baxter came at the last minute.
Good fist. Timing. Yep, good fist. I actually thought he knocked it through from behind, but got it to the boundary, which is even better.
So he'll be thrown back into play, deep inside forward 50. Sheehan got the front position. Holman was at the back, though, and just got a fist on it. He brought it to ground. It hasn't gone far. Once again, plenty of numbers around the footy. And surely umpire just called for it.
I like what this umpire's doing, Dave Chaston. He's letting it go. He needs to get the word across to the other two, but that's how we're umpiring in these conditions.
That's how we do, and we don't just blow the whistle and try and clear it for any old half-free kick.
Johnson over the top, gets it to Rounds.
Holding the ball.
Holding the man.
No, holding the ball against Johnson. He took it out of the ruck and had a fresh area on the kick.
Okay, all right. So free kick goes to House. He will kick this. Tim with the double M.
Would line up. Just come up with a double fist or something there, Johnson, to clear the area instead of trying to grab it out of the ruck.
So when he comes, head over the footy. Runs off to the right, and that's where the kick goes. Straight out to the right.
Oh, it was coming back, though, sharply.
It was coming back.
Another behind. So it's two behinds to Newtown. One straight kick to Bell Park, and it's one goal to. How long have we been going?
We've been going about five. No, we've been going, we've been going a lot longer than that. You forgot again.
maybe five to go.
I was just going off the first game on the iPad here, which was been going 4.5, and I thought we're surely the same, but no, we're not.
It's 2:32, so we've been going 20 minutes. Ball comes up. It's on the centre wing. Oh, gee, Hinkley just knocks it towards the boundary line. Ian Alley gets a kick forward. Garth leads in the race. Also, there is Polky. Good pick up on that occasion. Who was that with the long sleeves? Have to wait
and see who that is. Farrell.
Ball comes back into the pocket. Gee, Ian Alley was the target, but he missed him. And that was Hutchison who put it over. He said, put it out in the full.
Yeah, that's really
bad
poor,
use there. That's poor use. Matty McMahon, back pocket. Hugs the boundary, goes very, very wide. Fanning is the target, takes the chest mark. Right in front of the coach's box. They'll be happy with that. The big fella, although he did only outmark Rawlings, which is a bit of a height advantage, goes towards. There's a good mark
it's
from Jai Sheehan.
Contender for today.
Yeah, well, today we mightn't get much better. You might have to write that one down, Jai Sheehan.
We'll jot it down.
Yeah, you better, because we mightn't get much better. Sheehan goes to centre half forward, looking for his brother. The ball goes down to ground level. Rawlings at ground level. Dishes it out. Oh, gee, the Newtown player, did he duck his head? Umpire says, give it to me, and we'll ball it up. Cam Lewis there, the player I couldn't pick out. And it's going to get worse when they start getting dirty.
Yeah.
Palmer knocks it to ground. Comes out the back to Anderson. Goes round his body to no one in particular, and it ends up going over the boundary line. Throw in, 20 around, Newtown goal. A trail by 4 points. 2 points plays one goal on the Blood Toyota scoreboard.
Been the better team for the last 10 minutes, Newtown. It's been up their end. It's just hard to score today.
So thrown back into play. 30 around from the Newtown goal. Holmes in a good position. Just tries to slap it out of the area. He's knocked it out towards the line. Getting there first though and doing well. That was a swap rick, but Henderson was good for Bell Park and he's just worked it up the field. Ian Alley tried to get to the front. Strong tackle there laid by Hutchinson, but his opponent there didn't have the footy, so it'll be a free kick against him. I reckon it could go the way. His slop is just going that. And gather his own footy. So he's got it out on the wing, on that outer side in front of the coach's boxes. He just gets on the left boot. It was a bit of a mung going forward, but it worked out. I think that was Sheehan getting involved, gave it off. Lewis throws it on the right, but he's just going to go towards a dangerous position. But no, it's House tried to take it on the line, but it was already over.
Yep.
Out in the full next to the behind post there. So Baxter will bring it back into play.
Oh, up on the screen. How much clearer is it than trying to look at there?
It's sensational. The glare out on the ground is pretty painful. Benstead brings it out of defence. Went over the head of his intended target, Farrell, getting involved with Polky. Gave it off. Farrell sidestep. He's been super early. Yes. Then he just goes the grubber out in front. He's put it out in front of Stack. He's going to get there first, and he'll just soccer it again. This is good little tactic here. They've gone forward, picking up now is Ian Alley. He's got Homer in the middle. He might go to him. Patton will gather it. He's going to have a flying shot on goal. He'll get on the left boot. He's trying to steer this one back, but the wind holds it out to the left for a minor score.
Nice play into the conditions there. It was smart by Farrell to go along the ground. Gave him his teammate a chance to catch up. Bit of a rugby style.
He went sort of, he went that end over end kick, didn't he?
Patton had a bit more time there too. Quiz by the boys. Hinkley kicks out. Oh, Polky almost gets up and takes one. Comes over the top there to his teammate there in Rawlings. Oh, over the top of Ian Alley. Good fist. Comes
out. Paddock.
Has absolutely Lewis, that is. Cam Lewis. Goes, just amongs it into centre half forward. And the call of leave it by his teammate there from Mitch Alford. Says, I'll get it. Goes wide. He's got a team. Went to the direction of Rawlings. Rounds, rather. But does really well to get back in the contest. Comes out to Schwabrick, gives it across to Connolly. Not Connolly, Condy.
Billy.
Billy. Ball comes out wide. Jackson Sheringham. Just an up and under kick to real, no one's real advantage. Ground level. Ball comes out to Polky. Good hands, he goes. Gets it out to Billy Henderson. Henderson on to Stack. Stack's got plenty of pace if he wants to use it. Goes to the hot spot at centre half forward. One on three here. That's Fanning. Just knocks it to ground level. Good work from Garth. Keeps Bell Park in the contest. Picks up by, can Ian Alley pick it up? He's got two to beat. They get over the top of him. Loose ball, out the back. Sandy Robertson dishes out the handball. Goes wide. Condy gets it across to Braddock. And the boundary line's a winner. And thank God for that.
It just kept going for
you. Slowly running out of
breath. Sitting here waiting for a gap. And it
get me a bloody can of Coke.
And some chewy, that alcohol breath. Red wine smell just wafting through the box. Throw back into play. Laurie had the front position. There's going to be a free kick going the way of, as there's a couple of sore players on the ground. Maybe going the way of Newtown. Just trying to pick up who that is. He's quite sore.
I thought it looked like he
had... He's in a lot of pain there.
Who is it? Absolutely, oh, that's ridiculous. Can't even see a number.
Yeah, this early stage. 46. Daniel Goodwin, I'm going to take a guess at.
Yep,
he's just going to go short. He's got Hinkley. He can go for a little bit of run before he's tackled by Sheringham. He got the hands off just in time to Matty McMahon. He's just going to bring it out towards the wing. Cam Lewis is in space. He tried to take it before... Well, it was there, really. Eventually, he was able to gather the handball over to make him money. He just kept running through it up to himself, and Lynch intercepted it. Timmy Sheringham's just going to handball in board. There's Farrell again. He's been really good. His foot skills are good on this occasion. A short one to Jackson Sheringham. He's just going to go for a little bit of a run around Robbie Condy, and then the umpire, Laser Shepherd, goes inside the forward 50, and Goodwin can intercept and reload there for Newtown.
Good call there, JP. Fantastic. His ball finishes up with Stack. Stack goes into half forward. Oh, good judgment there to let that land and... has a crack at him.
Oh, he stuffed
minor
it.
Minor score.
Polky, it was.
Polky, wasn't it? Yeah.
Polky forgot which boot he wanted to kick with.
Minor score to Polky. Just couldn't pick him up there for a minute. The mud's just going to make it worse.
This is going to be...
you know what we'll be saying? Bell Park's got it. Newtown's got it.
And every now and then you'll throw in a Dragons or an Eagles. Or
oh, the kick out. Oh, Tyler Stack had a chance to just make him pay. Drop the mark. Got another chance. Dishes off to Jackson Sheringham. Quick hands. Goes over to his teammate there in Hutchison. But getting back, Hinkley takes a good saving mark in the last line.
I'll tell you what, lucky Hinkley's got a glove on. You wouldn't be able to pick him otherwise. You can't see that number.
Hopefully
he's just trying to
clear. Travis Cloak style.
Nelson Ram was over, and then the kick off the ground was probably living in danger. The umpire has paid it too.
Yep. Chubbs, that's what... Conway Buzz used to call him.
Oh, yeah.
Chubbs Hinkley. Yeah.
So Brown, he's just going to kick this one up the wing. He was looking for Anderson. The kick missed him. Benstead was able to gather it really well. He's just gone short along the line. He's found Rawlings. He's been in and amongst it early. He's just tried to spear along the line. Ian Alley shoved his man out of the way and then gathered and was tackled. Tried to break away, but it'll just be a throw in over there on the boundary line, just around from the club rooms.
Don't you rain, please go away. Please.
I'd rather that than wind, it's freezing.
Spinning ball, big shorts, Vale knocks it down at ground level. Oh, good spin out of trouble there. Oh, it looks like Hutchison. Play on, says the umpire. It's right in front of the Newtown crowd, so they didn't like that. And the ball's set upon, they're circling. Ball up. And a bit of feeling, which, as you boys mentioned earlier, will happen today.
Ooh, yeah, and Condy was dumped there. And look at it, it's fairly on now there too.
Half the pack's trying to decide which way to go, the ball or the fight.
That's so, a good pick up by Johnson. And he looks at the umpire, so he reckons he got it in the back. Ball trying to crash through with Billy Henderson. He's wrapped up in a tackle and you're gone, son! Sorry, that was Paddy Bright there, not Henderson.
Yeah, so Lewis will be the recipient of the free kick here. He's just going to give it a ride up the field as the rain. It's just slowly starting to work its way into this one. Bell Park were good with the intercept,
and then slipping over
at the wrong time. That's allowed Dolly to get involved. He gathers it eventually, and he's just going to hope he gets a good bounce here. He's kicked it towards goal and just goes the wrong side of the post, and eventually gets over the line in front of Chincotta.
Chincotta was over the top. He could have just kicked it to him.
So it'll be Bright to bring the ball back into play. That's Paddy Bright. He's just going to spear it out to the pocket. It needs to be a good kick. Sheen was going to try to get across. Couldn't do so. So on that outside, I reckon that's Alford with the footy in hand. He's just going to go short up towards the half back flank. Stack works into a good position. He just runs around Anderson.
Could
now he's going
to
give it a ride.
Stack.
He loves these sort of conditions, a little bloke, and he just goes up towards wing. Holmer was in the contest. And I reckon he's going to get a free kick in that one on two. No, the umpire's going to throw it in.
Stack's ability to get some speed and break away from the opposition and get a long kick in is going to be vital.
Absolutely, mate. Yeah, well, look at the wind take that. That's good. He's thrown that into the wind. Umpire says free kick in the ruck.
Finally called one.
Yep. This one fanning the recipient. Calling for the handball. As Command, he's ignored him. Goes down the line and only straight to the opposition. Mark to Johnson. Benny Johnson takes a mark at the half back. Got to have been going 30 minutes. He unloads back towards where it came from. Holmer up, goes over his head and we'll have a throw in. Right out there in front of the Bell Park coaching staff that's in the back of the truck.
Yeah, we'd nice be elevated about, position.
Oh, elevated. They're about 30 centimetres off the ground. Barely higher than the fence. So Bell Park, they try to get this ball going forward. Ian Alley at the front position working. There's rounds. He's taken out of it by Condi. Holmer comes for a bit of support. And over the line it goes in front of the Newtown interchange. And there's a sort of coach's box you'd be half proud of.
Bit of a bird's eye view, that one. It's so hot.
It's not like, look at the wind take that. The throw in has gone 15 metres to the advantage of Newtown. The ball, Rob, I reckon that's Michael Condi's at the bottom of that pack. And the umpire says, give it to me, we'll have a ball up.
Interestingly, when that throw-in got taken by the wind, it went straight to the ruckman because they were 5 metres behind the contest.
Yeah, I was struggling to catch up. So it's thrown up again. It's Vale and Fanning. They're too stuffed to care. It just hit the ground. Eventually, the ball went forward. Kerman tried to gather it. Patton's there as well. He just falls over. I don't know what he tripped over there. And now he stands back up with the ball and he's tackled by Billy Laurie and McCondy there. We'll have another stoppage. Record numbers coming today.
And this is before they get tired.
Exactly. Oh, Vale just, he threw a fist at it.
If that had landed, it would have knocked someone out if that had landed.
There's Benstead just standing up in the tackle. No, he was laying the tackle on Anderson. So another stoppage out on centre wing there. The rucks do battle again. It's Fanning and Vale. It comes off Rawlings' hands, keeps going forward for Bell Park, just going in with Smith. He took out his man and then just went back in after it again. And another stoppage, Milky. This is getting repetitive.
Eight goals might have been a bit of an overstatement.
Oh, yeah. We've seen. What
4 goals might be enough
yeah,
today.
Yeah, that's it.
Well, Leopold's having no worry with goals against North Shore. They kicked 7 in the first term out there.
Michael Condi goes round the body, puts it in the path of House. He taps it to his teammate's advantage. Lewis, goes off the side of the boot, goes back to House.
Kicked
Nelson
with his
Brown
heel.
Recovered from almost being killed in front of us here before. He's okay, Mum, so don't worry about him. Good fist away there from Johnson. Puts it in the path of Alford. He spearing kick. Goes to Farrell. Almost makes the most of it. Henderson, a good kick along the ground. Puts it in front of Smith as the siren goes. And there's the quarter time score, guys. 1-2-3 behinds on the Blood Toyota scoreboard.
Oh, she's a high scoring affair
here.
It's
a close one.
Reckon.
I think it'll remain that way.
Turned each other too, didn't they?
They turned on each other. Very funny. Back in the middle. Start of the second quarter. Up they go. Fanning tries to jump early. Knocks it down. Matty McMahon tries to get a handle on it. Fanning.
Ooh,
free kick going to Matty McMahon for a hold, I think.
Good game to the GD, by the way, by the sounds. It's good.
Yeah, we didn't even get to him. We got other things to worry about. Look at the hit. It's still there, Milky. It, recent searches.
Well, that's because you must be doing it. You're the only one using it.
Try
concentrating
when
here.
The game gets boring.
McMahon kicks it out here. Farrell chips in and takes a mark. Plays on immediately. A little bit too hasty, I think. Garth was on his own. but he's managed to kick it out in the full.
Nothing any good going in. Oh, actually, there might be one here. Thompson's got 9 points on Anarchy. That's closest of anything in the GD. The rest seem to be blowouts early.
Sandy Robertson takes a relieving kick. The wind's got hold of that and has pushed it right into the guts. Jackson Sherringham puts one hand up. Gets over to his brother Tim, who's tackled as he tries to kick it. Condy throws a boot at it. Now Farrell, who's been had a really good game so far. Picks, tries to get it forward, goes to Ianelli, who goes to ground, goes back and gets in the contest again. Farrell's in there as well, threw it out the back. He just tossed it and gets a free kick against him.
Yeah, so Newtown will just get an opportunity to get into attack. They need to get their first major of the afternoon. They're just going to go out wide. Short kick there, finds Dolly. And he's got stuff all going up the line. Fanning wants to move, but he's just trying to warm up. He ran too close to him in the end. Dolly's just had to go down the line. Vale, look who, he left him on. Vale said, stuff you, I'm too cold to run with you. And it landed on his head. He gave the hands off to Baxter. He's just roasted one down, and Garth was underneath. He couldn't quite hold it. Gets out the back there. I reckon that's Ianelli. He got to it first. He just gets all, look at the puddles out there. He just gathered it and went towards the hot spot. It's come off hands. Polky's just done the left boot out. It's grubbering towards the line, and now the soccer off the ground. It'll be the goal. I reckon that's Timmy Sheringham he's got back there.
No. It's Hutchison.
Hutchison, there we go. And how's that?
It's a single-digit number. I'm pretty sure it's Hutchison who socketed it off the ground.
Helped himself to a tap-in there.
Yeah, I reckon it's Hutchison. He's just been right man, right time.
I had five muddy numbers to guess between exactly, and I got the wrong one.
Not a lot of difference between 2 and 7, mate. I'll back you up there.
Oh, cheers, Milky.
Yeah, I'm not going to shoot you for that one.
Sensational. Just waiting.
I'm in a good mood today. Feeling sorry for everyone, including myself. So on the Godding scoreboard, that takes Bell Park to 2-2. They lead Newtown, 3 behinds.
Usually when you're hungover, you're hating the world, not Milky. He's loving it. Yeah. Fanning gets the tap down. Matty McMahon was there trying to charge his Rawlings and a free kick to Matty McMahon.
Two in a row.
Yeah, threw the head back there, Matty. Yeah. Good work.
So he's just looking for a leading target. He's just going to have to give this one a ride out towards the wing, trying to get up to the footy and taking the mark there. That was Braden Hocking. He just plays on quickly. He's gone out and across, and he's found diving in, taking the mark. Is that one of the Sheens there?
No, it's Braddock.
Braddock coming off the wing.
Sideways, and he's just dived forward.
And Braddock's been straightened up, and then he's just going to go spearing a low ball. He's looking for Mickey Condy, and getting across there was Patton, who gave the hands off to Benstead. Probably should have gone back and taken the kick, put Patton under pressure. He's just gone out towards the line, and the runner's just watching it very closely and picks it up, and then gets his first stat of the day.
I just watched the umpire. He's looking at the other umpire. He's thinking, do you want me to pay deliberate? Do you want me to pay deliberate? he just throw in right in front of the Newtown coach's box. Up goes. That was old Rawlins goes up and has a swing at it. Bought Baxter leads in the race. Knocks it clear. Over the top there, I reckon that was Alford. And he's dispossessed. Umpire says, you dropped it, son. The Bronx cheers
from over in the Newtown area. Obviously, a few Bell Park fans have gone in amongst them.
Infiltrated it under the roof there.
Yeah, so Benstead's just going to kick it up, and he's found Fanning. Unfortunately for him, Fanning just took it on the chest. He's done that a couple of occasions today. He's just going to go looking inside forward 50 at Sheen, and House got hands on it, but came off them
just
and went over the line. Stuck. And I'll tell you what, our man in the back of the box here, he's going to have a hard time carrying all that food back. We've put in a fair order today.
As that heater keeps going, I'm happy.
Must be nice down your end. Yeah, not getting much heat.
I actually just got a bit of it too, as Milky leant forward.
Yes, rounds, dispossessed. Umpire says, you dropped it. Free kick to Newtown.
Bell Park fans aren't as happy now.
Free kick to Matty McMahon.
It's his third of the quarter.
Yes. Just goes to centre-half forward. Tim Sheringham puts a hand in. Jackson's there to help him. He's tackled as he goes to the ground. Gee, ball's in a scrum now. I reckon that's Michael Condy. No, it's not. It's Cam Lewis. But umpire says, doesn't matter who it is. I'm going to have a ball up 40 out from the Newtown goal.
So Johnson just with the two palms just trying to slap it out of there. But it's going to come back pretty quickly, getting into the front there and sliding him a Sheen. It's going to ground level. Johnson went back to get it again. Sheringham got involved. There's Lynch. He just throws it on the boot and clears the area. He's gone up towards the...
It just skidded
into the lap of Polky. He's got a runner in Farrell who's showing plenty of dash to get forward of the pack. It's out in front of him. He needs it to sit. It didn't quite do so. It does so eventually. Gets the left boot on. He's just put it across the face. That was some really good play there for Fowell Park. Fowell just put on the afterburners to clear the area, but a minor score in the end, Milky, and you're the one that's all over the score today.
Yes, it is 2-3 to 3 behinds.
It's nice and easy when there's not a lot on that sheet.
Yeah, what are you saying? If it wasn't, I wouldn't be doing it.
No, your maths would be struggling.
Comes out, touches and throws a boot at it, can't get it. Clean hands, comes back to Michael Condy. His kick smothered. His brother Rob's in there. He's tackled as he gets the footy. Still at ground level. In fact, he paid him for dropping it when the ball was at the ground. He didn't even have it. The ball was at his feet. Rounds, gives it over to Jackson Bright. Up and under he goes to the hot spot. One on two. Ball comes clear and it goes out to Billy Laurie, who tries to pick it up. I thought he had that in clean hands. Couldn't do so. Comes out the back to Braddock again. Set about to Matty McMahon. Goes for it, then drags it in. Clever enough to tap it out, though. Crashing his way through. I reckon it's Benstead. He's at ground level. Ball in dispute. We'll have a ball up. As the cavalry has arrived, we've got chips, we've got pies, we've got coke.
Oh, this is sensational. This has made my day. So it's thrown up. Vale just tried to get a palm on, clear it out of there. But look, he's out the back. There's Rounds just clearing the pack and then shanking the kick off to the left-hand side.
That's a shocker.
That's a rubbish finish.
Would have been a handy goal, that three-goal lead in this game.
Yep.
Could have been real trouble
for Newtown still yet to kick a goal.
Haven't kicked a goal yet, correct.
So it looks like Sandy Robinson down there is just going to go short to Robbie Condy, and he's made him work, and he's juggled it across the line. He's going to claim that stuck in the mitt, but I don't think he can.
It's definitely a fair sort of juggle.
So now Bell Park's still got another opportunity here. It'll be thrown back into play into a dangerous position there. Garth doing the ruck work. He just got a fist on and got it out the back, trying to get involved. There was Bright then laying a strong tackle. Once again, though, not going far. The umpire calls for it pretty quickly on this occasion.
Thought he was taking a free kick.
There you go. Rawlings thought he had it.
We all dumbfounded what was going on.
What the hell's going on here?
He knew something nobody else did.
Umpire goes back, throws it up. Gee, trying to crash his way through on that occasion, the Newtown defender, but it goes back to Patton. He's dispossessed. Comes out to Rawlins. He gets it across. Come on, gets it, and goes to Fanning. Lucky kick. Right place, right time. Kick goes off the side of his boot. Goes in the Sheehan direction. Sheehan has Alfred to beat. Comes off the deck, there goes Cam Lewis. Johnson right in front of the kicks, commentary truck, tackled, dispossessed. Baxter goes in to help. Can he pick it up? Tries to dish off the handball to Lynch. Goes the 1-2, but he drops it. Then slaps it out. Good work here from the Newtown boys. Sheehan goes in, then manages to get a boot on it. Benstead tries to crash his way through. Could be in a bit of strife here, and he is. Gornski.
He had that look at the tackle, didn't he? Yeah. Decided he was going.
Super tackle, wasn't it? So that'll be... Is that Sheehan? Zach Sheehan with it.
Yep.
So Zach Sheehan, he's just outside 50. Johnson's standing the mark right on 50, I reckon. He's just going to spin into the pocket. He's got Chincotta going for the lead at the front there with Jai Sheehan. He couldn't quite hold it. Benstead was involved at ground level, wrapped up really quickly. He's not going to get pinned twice. No, the umpire called for him to have a ball up. So we're about 35 around from the Newtown goal. They're still trying to snag their first major of the afternoon.
Milky's going to gulp this coke all in one.
Milky's going to smash it down. Here's Matty McMahon. Look at this. He'll just spear one in from the boundary line. It's come off hands. Got out the back. And that's Sheehan. He's just socking one off the ground after the Bell Park player there. I'm trying to pick up
Alfred.
It just went straight through the mitts.
And
Newtown get their first of the day. And on the Godding scoreboard, they've just moved along to 1-3-9. Bell Park 2-3-15. We've travelled almost 9 minutes in this second term.
Those are the ones that you wake up.
There's a clock, obviously, on the scoreboard.
There is a clock on the scoreboard saving the day. I knew that all along, Milky.
Yeah, that's it.
Alfred will wake up with nightmares from that one. Threw his hands into his opponent's boot, basically. He shattered about that.
Yep.
As an old fullback, that would be devastating.
Yeah, you don't forget those either, do you?
Your opponents don't forget them either.
So back in the middle, 9 minute mark of the second quarter for Newtown to get their first goal. Up we go. Vale knocks it down. McMahon in, tries to drag it with him. Oh, big shorts. Vale just crashes his way like a rugby player. And the ball in dispute again. Wrap it up. Umpire will ball this up for the 495th time. Just outside the centre circle. All of that, we've moved the ball 10 metres. Up we go again as JB stuffs some chips into his gob. And Sheringham, Jackson, round the body he goes. No one on the end of it. Ball up. At the end of that, though, is Garth. Just good judgment. Pushes his opponent out of the way. Polky picks it up. Goes around the body with the left. He had Henderson.
Had Henderson over the top.
Falling over the top, and he ignored him and kicked the minor score. That's his second behind to Polky. Yep.
In dry conditions, you'd back Polky to kick that. But on this day, you've got to give that one over.
Look at Nelson Brown. He's obviously gone with the theory I'm not allowed to go over the fence, and he waits for someone to get it back to him.
Oh, thrown it into the mesh.
trying to throw it through mesh, that's always going to be difficult.
Well, what it's designed for to stop that from happening.
So it'd be Brown to bring the ball back into play. He just kicks it to himself, a little bit better than Maynard last night, Milky. He made an absolute meal of it. He's just gone up to the half-back flank there.
Was it footy on last offense. Night?
Yeah, you were too blind to notice. So they're all just going in there, getting involved there. That was Swarbrick was there, and then the kick from the machine around the corner goes further afield there. Condi tries to lay a tackle on Baxter, but he was able to get clear, and he's just roosted this one forward. It's got out the back. Sandy Robinson will get there first if he can pick it up. He's a tall lad. He gets down eventually, tries to handball it out of the
good
area.
Good here from the
really forwards. Good stuff, and they've just managed to lock this one in there, tight on the line. The clearing kick out of there only went as far as Lynch. Look at him burst through. He can't quite gather the ball. If he had it done so, he was running to the goal. That was Rawlings picks it up. He just got out of there eventually. Henderson gathered. He was tackled out the back to Stack now. He tries to charge through one as well. Can't break the tackle, and he's wrapped up. And we'll have a ball up 35 rounds from goal.
Good precious stuff from the Bell Park
piece
forward.
Piece of physical footy there, that play.
So it's 40 out from the Bell Park goal. They lead by a straight kick. A chance to put some more scoreboard pressure on. Up over the top, Sandy Robertson. Tries to clearing there. Was that Farrell trying to crash his way through? No, it was Rawlings, his twin, as the ball goes in dispute again. Trying to find the umpire, actually, and he says, nah, nothing doing. We'll have another ball up. Just about the same spot with the last one.
I reckon this quarter's been a little bit more open too.
The ball's definitely gone end-to-end a lot of this quarter. They pushed him over.
Yeah, it's obvious. A fair sort of shove. And Holmer, that was as obvious free kick as the obvious ball patch on the top of his head, Milky. So I reckon on the outer side there, that looked like Laurie just trying to get away from there. He just went short up the field. Got a mark taken there. Sheehan taking a punt, I reckon it is. There's that many long sleeves today, and they all look very similar. Just stepped Dolly. Around one. That was Dolly. Did really well. He's going to go up the wing. He's going to a contest. Comes off hands. Out the back there was Lynch. He couldn't gather it. Breaking through there. Sheringham. He's done really well. Got the hands off to Bright. He's got a number out wide there. And Johnson now. He's just going to get it on the boot, and he's just going to kick it along. He's going to a contest as well. Sitting underneath there was Henderson. It didn't work out for him. Farrell got involved. Tried to give it off to Hutchinson. Now getting it is Homer. He's slipped. Gets the handball away. Not quite. Newtown are away now. Slipped. And they can just get the kick going. Going forward, came off hands. Anderson came in and got involved. Gave it up top. Chincotto with a smart little tap.
Look at this.
Kick forward.
Fanning,
he's tripped over his own feet. Picked it up and he's got it on the boot now. Going forward. Trying to work here for him. That looks like...
Josh.
Is that Josh Sheehan? Yeah, they all look the same. As I said, Chincotto, we got his man too high. And Alfred. And Alfred to get the free kick. Kick to Alfred. That's in half back. He's just going to go backwards quite some way. It'll just stick in the mud. Now having to work, there's Rounds. He just goes for a little bit of a run, just throws it on the boot. He's gone long, and how's the hit? It's just straight off the chest of Henderson, though. It's going to work out for Newtown. They've got the numbers out the back there. Braddock got involved. He's just tipped it further afield. And they'll just look for the slow build now. I think it's Johnson on the mark.
We had a repeat of your YMCA because the Bell Park coaches were in the background when Henderson dropped that mark.
A good joke you run with once, Milky. You don't you don't use it to death.
That was you, wasn't it? That said that.
I did.
The YMCA.
And I used
best
it
thing
once.
You've ever done.
Used it once.
Only time you've ever been funny in your life.
I made sure I just didn't overuse it, like the dement works, which was, we got a slight laugh the first time.
No, you keep going. I'm going to bore you blokes to death. That's a plan. This Rounds has got it. You might wonder why we're just chatting, because this game is... I reckon 8 goals is a big overstatement. It might be 8 goals combined. As Rounds goes round his man, kicks a long bomb into the centre of the ground. Try over the top of the Bell Park player.
He's very
free
late
kick
on
to
that
Farrell,
one.
I reckon. I thought he'd called a ball up, and then Farrell gets a free kick. Had a chance to set up here, Bell Park, because there's a delay.
Newtown does.
Newtown defensively, yeah.
Bell Park
forwards.
Offensively?
So Farrell, is he just going to bomb it in? Yep, that's exactly what he does. Just bombs it in. But at the front is Patton. Just judges it beautifully.
It almost just held up, didn't it? All the players in the pack there at the back thought it was coming to him, was going to carry him, just dropped into Patton's hands. I reckon he was almost looking for the crumbs at the front of the pack.
Absolutely. That's what he would be there for. The little fellow at the front. Just superior judgment. He's kicking from 45 metres. Can he get the journey? If he does, it's right on the line. No. Touched on the line.
It was almost touched right into Polky's boots there.
Yeah, just about, if it had stayed in play. So Mrs. Brown would be very happy that her son has recovered, old Nelson. Kicks to himself. Should you watch? Should be out there cleaning his boots after the game. Nelson Brown. Oh, Patton at ground level.
Claim it.
Slips over and takes the mark.
That's almost a contender, that one as well.
Just about. He fell over and then dived and then took the mark.
We do need something.
Yeah, the game needs something. He dishes it off to Tim Sheringham, who gets around his man at top of the square. Trouble here, a throw they've called, and he's gone. He's picked him.
Great appealing from Bell Park.
Yeah, absolutely.
Edged through to the keeper, and they were all up in the slips quarter.
So kick at the top of the square is going to go to Hutchison, is it?
Yeah, it looks like
it. Yep, it is Hutchison. He's already got one. He's one of the three goal kickers on the ground, guys. He could be the only multiple goal kicker for the day.
Could be in the votes with two kicks.
Hutchison, 10 metres out, cannot miss this, surely. Puts it straight.
Oh, he's giving it a go. He's
did everything he could to miss that. From 10 metres out, managed to kick the goal, though. And that gives us 3-5 to Bell Park to 1-3 Newtown on the Godding scoreboard.
This is starting to get to a margin that you'd almost say is a little hard to get back at the moment. Especially in these conditions, once you get to your three-goal margin, it's going to be difficult.
It's hard work. It took them that long to kick their first goal in Newtown.
Yeah, and all of a sudden, it's got the response, so.
But it has opened up a little bit more this quarter.
Yeah, I think.
There's players in space a lot more than there was in the last quarter. Just depends whether they slip over or not.
Exactly. So we return to centre. It's Holmer up against Fanning.
Fanning slipped over here before. That was funny.
that was sensational. So Fanning and Holmer just went the jump. They both just hit the deck afterwards. Rounds was there trying to clear it, as was Condy, who got the kick out of there at the ball first. I've got no idea who it was, to be completely honest, this Martin. So Benstead, he's just going to clear it out of there. He's just kicked it out towards the other side. Yeah, there first was Hutchison, but the soccer off the ground was to the advantage of Newtown going after it. Again, that was Holmer at ground level, was trying to be strong. In there was Kermond as well. It's gone out towards the line. Jacko Sheringham can pick it up and sidestep a couple. He's run into a little bit of trouble, but ran out of it. Gave the hands off to Bright. He just stood on the boot around the corner. There's the carriage there. Seriously, good stuff from the Newtown players. Condy just threw a boot out. Didn't go far. It's ground level. Garth is trying to pick it up now. He can't do so. He's tackled without it. And the umpire's going to fall for the free kick.
Free kick. Fell for that. Or did he? Maybe he was tackled without
it.
I think he threw it well.
Threw his weight back a little bit too. So Garth just spears one inside forward 50. Henderson tried to take it on the chest, couldn't do so. Newtown now, they're trying to be good and try and clear this one. His slot was involved, comes back. There's Farrell out the back, sidestepped a couple, got the hands out.
Been good, Farrell.
Yeah. Been really good. Ian Ellis just had a right foot kick at goal, and it's gone out in the full.
He has been good, Farrell. He's been able to find space and get the ball to his teammates, which has been rare today.
Yep. So free kick in the back pocket. Commander will take it, or Sandy Robertson is to take this free kick. What can you do to get Newtown out of trouble down there? Deep in defence. Kicks it a long bomb, but it doesn't escape the 50, and a good mark is taken by Jackson Bright.
Wasn't a very long bomb then,
no,
was it?
It seemed to sit up, didn't it, when the wind. Bright just kicks it into the hot spot. Polky has the run at it, but it's defenders. Kicks it straight along the ground at Braddock.
And he's paid
it
too.
And he pinged him.
I think he did. He's almost gone one of those little banana kicks that makes out as though it's going away from the line, but curls its way back.
So the free kick now to Jackson Bright. He would just about be 45 out, I reckon.
Yeah.
Likes his chances, though, by the looks.
That's a seriously tough kick.
Kicks it to the hot spot, and
out on the full.
Out on the full.
Yeah, now that's a serious waste.
You've
got to
be just putting
kick.
That at the top of the goal.
On a day like this, that's the only spot you go.
So the free kick to Nelson Brown on this occasion. But, even to try to get it to the right side of the goals was a silly thing to be doing.
So the ball will come back into play against Sandy Robinson. He's just speared one along the line.
No, it wasn't Sandy Robinson. He just marked it.
Don't you hate that when they just point out the obvious to you? So Robinson, he's just going to go really, really short to Kerman. That has gone 8.2 metres.
Yeah, look out.
Kerman just plays on. He's going to switch the ball, and he's got a one-on-two out here. And the mark was taken. That's good. So Newtown will work their way up the wing now, sitting underneath it at the back. There's Goodwin. He was up against a couple. That was Braddock going in there strong, as was Benstead. Farrell got involved, got the hands out the back to Sheringham, who's just going to get a boot on this and just rooster towards centre half forward to the pack. Garth was too strong.
Massive push.
Tried to take it with 1 minute against his chest, and it came to ground level. Free kick going the way. too high, the umpire has said.
Did you see Garth shove?
Probably cleared the way for him.
So getting out of there was Hutchison. He's just got a swinging ball back towards the top of the square. It's bounced. Oh, it's almost gone through.
Sheepers.
Sandy Robinson just said, I'll let it bounce. It's a wet day. I'll trust it. And it'll come back to me. And it's just slid away from him. He's just lucky to get a palm on it.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Goalkeeper style diving across.
Wow. So Nelson Brown. Yeah. He'll bring it back into play.
Kicks it to himself. Then goes to the outer side. Ball fisted to ground level. Stacks on. Umpire circle. He's blown it. He's pinged him. He's pinged the Newtown player. Bottom of that. Is that Josh Sheen at the bottom of that? No, it's Dolly. Dolly at the bottom of it. He's pinged him for no attempt.
Full set.
21 minute mark.
I reckon that's Ian Alley with it. Only guessing from here. Ian Alley goes long. It was Patton, in fact. Goes to the top of the goal square. And rush through for a minor score.
Racking up these points, aren't they, Belfast?
Yep.
Yeah, a little bit wasteful, isn't it?
Had they kicked straight, mate, they'd definitely be saying game over, but the inaccuracy is keeping Newtown in it.
So it'll be Brown to bring the ball back into play again. He's just going to go out of side, just tell us where to go.
Three goals,
so he goes
seven.
Out there. Holman went up and just got a hand on it. He brought it to ground level. Condy was there to rove it, and he just got it around the corner. He got it going further afield, but Bell Park got the numbers. Oh. Jackson Sheringham just spun out of a couple, and then Ian Alley threw it on the boot, got it going forward, but it's a free kick. It's going to come back and go the way of Bell Park.
They're calling for it downfield. And
I would have thought it should be downfield.
They had numbers where the ball was too, Bell Park. They'd be not happy about this.
That's a real interesting decision there.
Yep.
Been dumped after he's kicked it.
Should have been.
It was before the kick, but it should have just been advantage, I think.
So Sheringham, he's just going to spear this one inside forward 50. He had Garth underneath it. He slipped and allowed his the defenders an opportunity. It's gone out wide on bottom of the pack. There is.
Jeez.
That's and bounced 50. Through, but 50.
50.
They've really been hot on the free Farrell. Kicks this quarter.
It was the 50 because he paid the free.
And Farrell's filthy because he kicked a contender and it was a free kick going the other way.
So the free kick to be taken by Laurie in the guts of the ground, just about. There's no one on the mark. Another 50. That must be two 50s. You've got to be...
Yeah, that's a long 50. So the free kick to be taken in the centre of the ground. I reckon that's Laurie who had it. He's just gone short and it's intercepted almost by Garth. He's got up the field. So Garth to set up here for Bell Park. He's got a few players running back with the fly calling for it. Garth just had to wipe his hands a little bit muddy and he's just gone out towards the wing. Getting back there's Polky. And look at him. Polky, no matter what the conditions, those hands are sticky. That is a serious contender. Your elite training centre contender, that is. So Polky's just going to go inside forward 50. Slipping over at the wrong time was Ian Alley. And he's allowed Nelson Brown to take one on the chest.
So Brown in the back pocket goes to Matty McMahon. He also lost his feet. Ball comes out. Jackson Sheringham.
Oh, pinged him for a throw.
Pinged him for a throw. Sheringham's the play on as a call from the umpire. Goes towards goal. Probably had a little bit more time. Another behind. So we got three. Is that two goals? Three goals, eight? They got 3-6 to 1-3 on the scoreboard.
They've kicked about the last six behinds.
Yeah.
Bell Park.
Two, three.
It's game complicated.
I make it eight. I make it 3-8. And they got 3-6 on the scoreboard. 3-6 to 1-3 on the scoreboard, but so we'll see
there
if that. We'll see who's correct. I think you'll find it is me, as usual. Nelson Brown to kick out. Just goes straight up the ground. Paddy Bright puts in a contest to Anderson. Kick, handball comes out. Wrapped up in a tackle is Rounds. Umpire says, you're Gonski. And we'll have a free kick to Newtown at half back. Free kick going the way of Matty McMahon.
Matty McMahon, what's that, his fifth this term, Barnsley?
Yeah, he's been racking him up.
He's had a few of them.
A lot more free kicks this term. Must have got a pep talk at quarter time.
From the bloke who was marking the lines down in the middle. That's the only reason he did it.
Matty McMahon, terrible. Shocker. Gets it out. Dolly gets it. Then he's dispossessed, but he manages to go back and get it again. Goes in the house direction. Baxter knocks it clear. Stack. Round the body he goes. Up and under. Gee, Billy Henderson's manhandled, and the umpire says so. He agrees with me. Free kick. Two.
It's against Henderson.
Wow-wee!
Well,
I am. The umpire's wrong.
So the kick comes up the line there and just smashing it over there.
Paddy Bright.
It was Paddy Bright involved. That was Stack. That was really good stuff there just to kill the footy. So he'll be thrown in centre wing. So we arrived to the later stages of this first half. Xander Robinson doing the ruck work, got it down, trying to get there's Dolly. He couldn't pick it up. Doing well there was Patton handballed off to Rawlings, but he missed him. Rawlings gathers it just as the line approaches, and he goes over it.
25 gone, 3-8, according to me, plays 1-3. 25-minute mark, and the spinning ball comes back in. Holmer knocks it clear to Bell Park's advantage. Henderson, and so to... Oh, Polky got one high, big time. And free kick to Polky.
He was put the brakes on at all. It was Polky that whacked him in the mush last quarter as well.
Yeah, he's might have just been gone for his square up.
So he saw his chance there, Brown.
And we could be...
Oh, hang on. We might have a report here.
Nelson Brown ran off. He's
We might have a report here.
The yellow card.
We don't have that pulling his, report. Got the book out. Boundary's in on it. Boundary's reporting him. And central and yellow a send card. Off. Wow.
Oh, I'm not sure.
If you report someone, it has to be a yellow card. That was worth a report, I'd say.
So, that's very interesting. Free kick to Polky.
Now, why is the umpire
What's
running off over
there? What's he following him for? Umpire's following Brown. What is he doing? What, is he just making sure that he... I've never seen that before.
Going to sit next to him for 15 minutes.
He followed him the whole way to give him the card. Again.
I've never seen that. So anyway, after all of that, it's Polky to have the free kick. Kicking from... He'll be kicking about 40 metres. And with the wind, if he puts it out to the right-hand post, the wind should drag it straight through the guts. In he comes. Puts it out there, and the wind has just dragged it straight through the guts, like I said. There you go.
Perfect commentary there, Bill.
There you go, mate.
Save that one. Save that tape for your highlights.
Yeah. We're going to write that down for the Elite Trading Centre, I reckon. For that reason that Milky got it right.
4-8, I make it, to 1-3. Very costly there to Nelson Brown. Oh, they're caught up. They've changed the scoreboard. They've caught up with me.
Jeez, it's all happening for me.
Yes, told you I was never wrong. So that's a critical goal, that one there, boys.
Yeah, so the break's starting to get a little bit too big here for Newtown. It's only half time coming up shortly.
Yep, and we've been travelling, let me see, 27, nearly 28 minutes. Been that only that little delay there for the report, but beyond that, back in the guts we go. Fanning wins it, knocks it down, crashing his way through his rounds though. Up and under his kick, leading in the race, Kelly. For Newtown, can't quite get there. Ooh. Free kick. Not sure to her. I think it's to Kelly. Must be for a hold. No.
No.
It's to Bill Laurie. I didn't see him in the contest. Yep. Goes back to Matty McMahon. He's got it at centre half back. Goes to the outer side. Up and under looking for Sheehan. Fists it away from him. Ball at ground level. Umpire circling says, give it to me. Balling it up right in front of what you would expect, a very happy Bell Park coaching group.
No, they just look cold.
YMCA, come on, do it. YMCA.
No, there's hands. Yeah, it's not a day for YMCA. It's hands in the pockets business today. So it was thrown up there. Matty McMahon was the ground level. He was working really hard for it. And then there was a soccer off the ground, which took it straight out of the line.
Up there, elevated position over there.
Elevated position.
Looking down on the ground.
They're standing on it to one side of it. And it's got a serious tilt on it that almost brings them back to ground level. It's a waste of time, and in the meantime, there was a deliberate paid for that soccer off the ground that I mentioned. So Stack took the free kick, and he's just sort of giving it a rooster half forward flank coming to the front. There was Holmer, he couldn't get there at ground level. They got the numbers to Bell Park. Now they're going to get a kick inside field 50 from Sheringham. It's going Farrell's at the front, tried to fly from an interesting position, free and the kick. Free kick going the way of there's Feeling again.
Here we go, they're into it now.
Well, there's two down, one from each.
Two down, and
they collided.
One of them's Farrell
trying to take that mark.
Yeah, one's Farrell, and I can't work out who the Newtown boy is. Is it Anderson, I think?
Farrell flew from the front, and as he collected someone on his way...
A Bell Park player came from behind and collected that Newtown bloke.
That's Polky.
And is Polky that and, cause, and then all the Newtown players were the first ones there to sort of remonstrate about it. So
Polky's been in the business.
Has Polky collected someone in all of that? Fanning's not too happy with Polky either.
Did he throw the footy at him?
Oh, he's going to Polky again.
He's got the reach advantage there.
Fanning has seriously seen something.
Yeah.
Newtown player still hasn't moved by the looks. He's rolled over.
Fanning had pattern there's a mismatch if I've seen one.
Back pattern.
It looks like he's going to be down for a while because both teams are calling for huddles.
He'd have to be knocked out. So there wasn't a knee or a... He's been hit and hit the deck, I reckon.
The umpire's getting together. They're trying to work out what the hell's happened too.
The umpire paid him the mark, so it wasn't anything major.
Yeah.
It was just a collision of bodies, I think.
Maybe Polky pushed him into Farrell.
Yeah.
Because that's about all I can think, because I didn't really see it.
Yeah, the umpire's just pulled a card out again.
Yeah, they're pulling cards out.
There we go again. Jeez.
Which could be huge for...
If Polky's out for a while.
The current B&F. Circle going into the... going into the Bell Park huddle, and he's gone to Polky, has he? Is it Polky that he's grabbed?
He's trying to find someone.
You weak animal, we heard from a supporter.
So is that Polky running off over there? Just going over the line now, so you'd suggest he's just been given the yellow?
Yep, but the Newtown player, injured player, where's he gone?
He was in the hands of the trainers, walking very slowly off the ground.
I can't see him.
He's straight through the middle. No, they're running away. I thought that's where it was.
Trainers are walking off on that.
Trainers
are
going
side.
Off. I don't reckon he's gone off there. The player.
Surely he'd have to come off and they'd have a look at him at least.
I don't reckon he's gone off the ground.
He didn't move.
But hang on, over the other side, near the doctor, in the blue. Is there two sets of legs there or only one? No, there is two sets of legs. Yeah. Yep. He just had to cover.
There we go.
Yeah, hit him for a while there.
Yeah, it did, didn't it?
Tucked him under his wing.
Still can't work out who it is, to be honest with you guys. Is it Hislop, maybe? Reckon it might be Hislop.
So, playback underway there. House got the front position and he's won a free kick for... trying to work out what the umpire's signalling. We're not sure what they're up to at the moment. So House is just going to go short. He's looking for Fanning. He just slid in.
Line up,
took
Fanning.
It on the chest. He'll be an angry bloke at half-time. He'll go looking for Polky, I reckon. He's just going to get the ball moving up the field now.
Look at that stop.
Look at that. He's just gone about 30 metres, and he's given it his all. Lewis is at ground level, but there's a free kick going the way of Newtown for another shove in the contest. Now, there's the half-time siren. And watch what happens here, but... at half-time, Newtown trailing 1-3-9, Bell Park 4-8-32. That quarter went all 33 minutes. That's on your Godding scoreboard, and we just wait for something to erupt.
Fun games as they go off.
There'll be a few words spoken in addition.
Yeah, you would have thought so.
Fanning's jogging over there. Look at him.
Are they getting over to have a word to the umpires here too? What's going on there?
Yeah, Bright just had a word to the umpire.
Yeah, he wasn't happy about it.
I thought it was only the captain's allowed to talk to the umpires.
Yeah.
But anyway, so at half time,